Today we will create a bifold brochure design in InDesign and create a print-ready PDF. This brochure will be recruiting prospective students to a university.
Let's get started. Go to File, New, Document. I'm just going to go over to Print Settings. There is actually the exact size that I need already in the print settings. It's a letter half. It's 5.5 by 8.5. I'm just going to click that. The width is 5.5, that's correct. And the height is 8.5. We're in inches. We do want portrait orientation for this brochure. You do need to have facing pages checked. So go ahead and check that. We are going to set our margins in the document. So let's not worry about setting them here. Click Create. Let's go ahead and save this file. Let's go to File, Save As. First thing we want to check is that our workspace is set up correctly. Set the typography workspace. Go ahead and click the pages panel on the right-hand side. And if you don't see it here for some reason, remember you can find all these panels by going up to window and looking for them here. Or you can also search for panels. So let's click pages. And I want to look at my page setup for this document. So you can see I have one page, but we're creating a brochure. This is a bifold brochure. So it's essentially a piece of paper that's folded in half. We're actually going to need 4 pages for this brochure that we're creating. I'm going to go ahead and create those 4 pages. If I go down here, say create new page, I'm going to click for one new page, another new page. And so there's our center spread. You can see the thumbnails here, and we need our back cover. My document went ahead and put some margins in, but I'm going to adjust those margins and change them. I'm going to select all of the pages in my pages panel because I want my new margins to apply to all the pages in my document. I'll click on one page, and if you hold shift and then click on the front page, it should select all of them at once. Go to layout, margins and guides. So it defaulted to 1/2-inch margins. I'm going to increase my margins just a little bit, 0.75 inches across the board. I'm going to start with just 2 columns. We'll see how that looks. And let's increase our gutter just a hair. I'm going to click OK. And just to double check that my margins appeared on all the pages, there's my front page, middle page. Today, I'm going to create a brochure that is for prospective students. My cover is going to have a nice fun full-bleed image with our logo and a message. The inside is going to have lots of good photography, and it's going to have some language about why you should come visit. And I'm going to have a call to action to visit on this page. And then the back is also going to have a call to action. So let's get started on this cover. I'm going to use my rectangle frame tool. I'm going to think about bleed as I'm designing today. All of my boxes, I'm just going to have them extend past the edge of my frame. So this is going to be my image. I'm going to go File, Place. I'm going to use a really fun image from a football game. I'm going to move this over. And I want the subject to be kind of on the right-hand side in this column so you can see more of the crowd. You can see a little bit of that jumbotron. Just checking my percentages up here. This image is big enough for my space. It's getting close to 100. I really couldn't make this image much bigger. I'm going to then add a color block down here. I'm going to just use my rectangle tool and draw a box. I'm going to extend it past our frame and go to swatches. I need to add a swatch, create a new color swatch. UT is 50 magenta, 100 yellow, and 0 black. I'm in CMYK color mode. There's my box, and it added a new swatch down here for me. I'm going to add a message on the cover. Create a text box. I'm going to go ahead and choose my font. I am going to choose Gotham. I'm going to make my font, let's try it, a little bit bigger. And I know I want my font to be white. I'm going to place it over this photo for now. And I'm going to see how this fits on top of the image. Break this text up just a little bit. I might want this to be uppercase. So I'm going to go back to my character panel, click the hamburger menu and say all caps, and then reduce my lettering just a little bit. I think I'm just going to put my logo right here. I am putting this text on my guide. It's aligning here on the margin. You go file, place. And I have an EPS file, which is a vector file of the logo. I'm putting it on an orange background for this brochure. So this white logo should look perfect. I'm going to say open. In the design, that's quite big. Reduce the size. You can also reduce the size with your percentage box up here. So I want this logo to align either with my message or maybe even center align it. I have a lot of guides showing right now, which is good. Kind of need to see this without the guides. You can either go up here to view grids and guides and hide the guides. There's also an option at the bottom of your tools panel. Click this, there is a preview option. So right now we're looking at the normal view. I can preview this design and it's going to show me what this design looks like with no bleed. All the boxes are gone. So this is a much easier way to look at this design. I'm just going to make a couple of adjustments. I'm going to go back to my normal view. Let's go to the inside. I want to have a photo gallery on the left and then some content on the right that promotes the university along with the CTA. I'm going to start with my rectangle frame tool and I'm just going to create some photo boxes over here on the right. I'm going to use my guides. I'm not sure what my arrangement's going to be yet, but I'm just going to draw some boxes and then fill them with some photos. Actually, I might do a big photo down here. Maybe something like this, maybe four photos. If you'll notice, I'm giving them all a little bit of space. So this little area here is white space between the photos. One of my rectangles selected, into file, place. I'm just going to start choosing some of my images here. And if I think of this arrangement, I have a big photo at the bottom. Maybe my most compelling photo should be the largest. And then I have some smaller detail images to go with it. I'm just going to choose an image for this taller one to adjust the size. So let's go ahead and try that smoky image. Okay, and then maybe some student interaction photos here. A student studying on the steps. Another photo of some students talking on campus. I'm going to use my preview view again and just take a look at this. Bring these photos a little bit closer together. Let's move to the content that's going to be on the right. Okay, with my guides back on, I'm going to select my type tool and I'm going to have a big headline up here. I want this headline to be big and orange so it matches my photography. Going down to my character tool, I'm going to choose the same font that I use on the cover. Make it bigger. I'm going to do all caps. Reduce the leading on that just a little bit. I think this font could go a little bigger. I'm going to make it 36 points, so the same size as the cover. I'm going to reduce the size just a point or two so it fits inside my margin. Let's add a paragraph of text. So using the type tool, I'm going to drag a box of text that extends across both columns. I'm going to right click and say fill with placeholder text. Let's change the font, select all. I'm going to choose a Gotham, probably a Gotham book. My body copy is at 12 point, which I feel like is a little big. I prefer more like a 10 point or an 11 point for body copy. Right now, this copy is black. I want to create a swatch for our smoky gray. New color swatch. I'm going to do an 80% black CMYK. I'm just going to adjust this text a little bit so I don't have weird paragraph breaks. I like this left aligned text. This feels nice. So next I'm going to add some bullet points right here in two columns. I'm going to create another text box. I'm going to choose similar font to my headline, but just going to make it smaller. I'm going to choose Gotham, Ultra again, all caps, and orange. I'm going to do another text box. I'm going to have it extend across both columns. Right click, fill with placeholder text. I want it to be the same as this. You go to your eyedropper tool, select all your text. So I'm actually going to use my eyedropper to sample this style. I click on the style of this text above, it changed the text below to match the exact same style. This is a very convenient shortcut, especially for body copy or headline styles that you want to use over and over. I mentioned I want to make bullets. I'm just going to break this up a little bit. I'm just going to pick some spots. That's about 7 or 8 bullet points. I'm going to select my text, hover over type, bulleted and numbered list, and say apply bullets. Okay, so now I have bullets. It actually added bullets for every single space, which I don't really want, but I'm going to do a shift return after each of these so it doesn't add a bullet there. I'm going to turn off these boxes here. I don't really like seeing these. So if I go under view extras, you can hide the frame edges. Here's a bulleted list. I actually want this bulleted list to be in 2 columns though. I'm gonna show my guides again. And I'm just gonna drag my text box over and make this text box, just put it in 1 column. You can see as I reduced the size of my box, the bullets went away. With my selection tool activated, you see this little red box that appeared? It has a plus sign. If you click on that box, you see some text that appears on your cursor. Now, if I click and drag and create a new text box, it is carrying over the text that is in this box into a new box. So it's just flowing it over. So if I adjust this, it's going to adjust this column. In a brochure like this, you would definitely use something like this pretty often, especially if you have paragraphs of text that need to connect or flow throughout your piece. I actually don't want all of these bullets showing, maybe even 4 bullets on each side. I'm going to get rid of some of these. I had mentioned wanting to put a CTA down here. I'm going to separate the CTA with a rectangle with color inside. So I'm going to draw a rectangle. And for now, I'm going to fill it with our smoky gray. I'm going to use a similar headline style to this right here. I'm just going to copy and paste this headline down here. I like this font size. I'm going to copy and paste a text box down below, turn my text white. I actually want this to be meaningful text. And I'm going to bold my phone number and my URL here so you can see them a little bit bigger. I'll go to my character tool. Instead of book, I'm going to use bold. Overall, I think this looks really good. I have really good hierarchy. There may be some things I could do to make this more interesting too with the photography. Maybe these photos go across my margin here. And then all this moves over. To do something like that. So when you open the brochure, it's not exactly like a photo panel and a text panel. These photos span a little bit further across. And this may not be exactly in my grid, but grid is just there to give you guides and give you an outline of where things could go, not necessarily where they have to go. Okay, so I have a cover design, I have an interior design, and I'm going to finish this off with another big photo on the back. I may even put like a student quote on this photo, also close with another CTA. Let's do a rectangle box using the rectangle frame tool. I'll do a full image for now and place. So if I am going to have a quote, I need a nice place for that quote. Maybe this is nice and centered on the back. I'm going to put another orange box in the back. I have no orange on the back anymore, so I need our UT orange to be present somewhere. I mentioned putting a quote here and another CTA to get more information. So just like I did earlier, I'm going to grab a few of my existing text boxes so I have my styles. And place them on the back here. I'm going to start with my quote. I'm just going to use my Greek text. And let's turn our guides back on and just see where we are. Actually, I may move Harris Hall over so our quote fits kind of nicely to the side here. I'm going to make the text in this quote just a little bit bigger. It's supposed to stand out a little bit. And one nice thing you can do with quotes is highlight the quote marks. Make them really big or do something interesting with them. I'm going to make them really bold and let's make them orange. I think they'll show up against this. Okay. All right, let's do our final CTA. My bold weight went away, so I'm going to just highlight this text. And remember, you can use your eyedropper tool to copy a style. So I'm going to copy, just click the style of my phone number. Let's take a look at this back without the guides. I have a logo on the front. I think we also need a logo on the back, because if you just looked at this back panel, you wouldn't know what school this is. So I'm going to put the UT logo. I'm going to line it under Iris Hall. And I already have it in the piece. I have it on the cover. So I'm just going to copy and paste it. So there's my brochure. Let me go back to my normal view. I'm going to show you how we would prep this for print. We would have to check all of our images with the links panel. So window links. If we have any images that are RGB, you need to change them in Photoshop to CMYK and also change the DPI to 300 DPI. Check all of your images to make sure the percentages are under 100 and that they are not stretched. So these numbers need to be the exact same. You would go image by image. You can also just use your links panel because this is showing all the links in your document. So you could just click down this list and look at what still needs to be prepped for print. So that's step one. We would need to make sure that all of our bleeds are there. Your images, graphics, color blocks, anything like that. A quarter or an eighth of an inch is sufficient. It looks like I'm extending a little past an eighth of an inch here, all around here. My images, each of them, is hanging off the side. So these are all good to go. This box is good to go. And let me just extend this just a hair. So I have bleed already set up all around my document. Let's save the document too. Double check that you don't have any RGB color swatches. All of these are CMYK. A lot of printers can actually print directly from a PDF, and it has to be a high-res print-ready PDF. So let's create a PDF for sending it to a printer. Go to File, Export. So I'm going to choose Adobe PDF Print. I'll just save it. Up here, you have high-quality print, which is usually pretty sufficient for printing. There's an even better print quality option called press quality. Going down here, we want to export in spreads because we have a cover, we have a center spread, and then we have a back page. Next, go to marks and bleeds. So this is where you'll want to set up bleed. PDF extends past your document line. I'm going to have bleed at a quarter of an inch. And then up here on marks, I'm also going to add crop marks. The printer knows exactly where to cut this print file. That should be all you need to do. So click export. My cover design, I can see the crop marks and I can see that the image is extending to the center spread. I have my crop marks on the back. So this PDF could be sent to a printer right now and they could print from this file. As long as your images are prepped for print, they are 300 DPI and CMYK, you will want to also send a package InDesign file to the printer. A lot of times I like to save my print ready PDF, save it as, so if this were my final, I would call it final with prof or print ready with prof, something like that. So I know that this PDF is the thing that I could send to the printer right now. So that's how you design a bifold print-ready file in Adobe InDesign. You can find links to download a prep for print checklist and find other InDesign tutorials in the description below. Subscribe to Cry Studio to learn more about InDesign and graphic design. Thanks so much.